Hello. Okay, last one. Last video, we're going to go through phase three. If you're watching this video, you've probably already watched phase one and phase two, and I wasn't too annoying, I wasn't too patronizing, so you thought you'd watch phase three. I really, really hope that this is helpful. Please let me know any feedback that you have, whether it's positive or negative, let me know, because so I know whether like you could do with some more, or if actually Miss Lopez, we know this already, you don't need to make these videos for us. Okay, so I'm Miss Lopez Live, Crystal Lopez. Just a quick reminder that I've got story time every day for 0 to 7 year olds on YouTube and on Instagram, and everyone is welcome. Okay, so phase three. With phase three, we continue learning sounds, but this is where we introduce digraphs and trigraphs. Digraphs are literally two letters that make one sound. Trigraphs are three letters that make one sound. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the letters, the digraphs, trigraphs, etc., from phase three. And then I am going to give you some ideas for games. I have just had a message saying that letter formation would be good. So I might go and have my dinner and then come back and do that. Okay, so let's go through the sounds for phase three. So you've got E, like in feet. Ow, like in cow. Sorry for the reflection. Ah, like in car. Or, like in door. Or sort. Like in burger. Ooh, like in boot. Or, this also makes the sound like in book or took. Or look. I, so I-G-H, I, like in light. Z, x, x, it's a bit like a whip. X, w, y, th, or th, so like th, like in thing, or that, th, or th. Ng, ng, like in string or thing. J, qua, like in queen. Sh, like in shop. I bet you like that one. Sh. Ch, ch, ch. So this is ch, like in chop. I realised they're backwards. It was just too much faff to get it the other way around. This video is more for parents rather than children anyway. V, that's a good one. A, like in rain. O, like in boat. O. Like in nurse. Like all our amazing nurses. Oi, like in oi. Or like in spoil. This one's a funny one, but I'm just letting you know, it's meant to make the word oi, ba, oi, or boil. It does kind of work, just depends on your accent. And then we've got trigraphs, so three letters. We've got air, like in hair. We've got your, another one that's debatable, but I'm letting you know the sound. Your, like in picture, picture, treasure, measure. But apparently it makes the sound your. Some people argue that if we live in London, we should teach them that it makes the sound but guidance is your for now. Ear, like in here with your ear. And I bet that will be one of your favorites. Let's practice that. And also, why don't you hear with your ear? So ear, ear. So those are the sounds, and then also, like I said in the previous video, there will also be tricky words, okay? If you didn't watch the previous video, I'll just give you a quick background of tricky words. Tricky words are words that can't be sounded out, so please, please, please don't attempt to sound them out. Children see them, they know them, they learn them, okay? And again, a big thing about phonics is make it quick, make it snappy, make it fun, make it kinesthetic, so you're kind of moving it. Kinesthetic, is that right? Make it, you know, move around, make it fun. Okay, so here are the tricky words for phase three. Mr. People, oh, my favorite. Oh, nothing, that's phase four. Maybe I should have sorted these before I did this. It's coming, sorry. We, he, her, was, all, are, you, they love that one, they, she, and I think that might be it. Yeah, so those are our tricky words for phase three, okay? And finally, some games. So if you didn't watch phase two, please watch it because that's fundamental to phase three. And actually, all of the phases are fundamental to each other. There were some ideas for games there. A really good game for phase three that the children love is that by now, they're going to be able to read captions. So it's a really good game where you can ask really silly questions and you can ask kind of yes and no questions and you can get them to say yes or no. So, and again, all of this is in Letters and Sounds online for free, okay? And it's like, not, it's not a scheme, so I don't have to like put the link in the bio or anything. It's just what most schools use, unless they're using like Jolly Phonics or Ruth Miskin. So yes and no games, that's a really good game. So getting them to read a caption, answer yes or no. They need to be able to read the caption, understand the caption to answer yes or no. And bingo is a really good one. You can also play this with phase two. So getting you write some words and then put it on a board, especially if you have other children, it's nice to play all together. And then you sound out words and they have to see they've got them, or just say words and they have to see if they've got them. Maybe get them to read all the words before so they know what words are on their boards. So that's another fun game. I was going to say something. What was I going to say? No, I think we've gone through it all. Oh, reading, that's it. If you didn't see in phase two, patience. Patience is the most important thing when reading and writing with your child. Trust me, even in school, when they are engaged, they are happy, they're learning, and we're doing everything to make it right, there are moments where it's not happening and they're finding it really hard and you're getting stressed and they're getting stressed. Remember, always in everything, really, take a break, especially with phonics, like just take the book and start reading it yourself, or just be patient. You need to just wait for them to read through the words, really help them blend it, really help them segment it if they're writing, and just be patient, okay? Because it does take time. Like, you think about how we learnt to read and write, and that it just takes a lot of time.